Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. We made up in our minds to rejoice and be glad therein. So grateful to God, so appreciative, so thankful for another opportunity to be able to come together as the body of Christ and to be able to continue to bombard heaven, to call on the name of the Lord. He is worthy of the praise and worthy of the glory, worthy of the honor, and we're so thankful for that. Thank you for so many of you that have been walking with us, been journeying with us during this time of consecration. I think the last time I paid any attention to the numbers that they send me on the calls, we've had about 50 or so people. That's not preacher numbers, about 50 or so people has been consistently jumping on the prayer call every morning. So I'm thankful for that. Thankful for the remnant. Thankful for the those of us that's a part of Truth and Love Ministries. And then our family and friends as well. Because as I say, you guys share this time with your family and your friends, whether it's a replay or whether it's a live call. And I know we literally have people that chime in from around the country, and we're grateful for that, that are friends of the ministry. They're part of the body of Christ, but they're friends of the ministry, and we're thankful for that. So it's been a pretty steady, consistent number, and I'm thankful for you all being a part of what it is that we're doing as relates to coming together at the beginning of the year, honoring God with the beginning of our year, and praying and asking him to be involved in what it is that we are doing. We're in day 13 of our 21 days of prayer and consecration. And I know God has is being glorified and has been glorified. So Father, we thank you. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. We thank you for this is the day that you made, a day that we made up in our minds to rejoice and be glad therein. And God, we're so thankful for being amongst the land of the living. We're thankful, God, for life, for health, for strength. We're thankful, God, for the use and activity of our limbs. We're thankful, God, for all that you've done and all that you're going to do. We call upon your name this morning. And God, we never grow weary of calling on your name. We never grow weary of thanking you and appreciating you for your love, for your kindness, for your grace, for your tender mercy, God, that you have extended towards your children. We'll never grow weary of that. We'll never get to the place, God, where we pray that we'll never get to the place, and we ask you to keep us from ever getting to the place, God, to where we take things for granted, where we don't slow down out of all the hustle and the bustle and our crowded schedules and the fact that we got to be here and be there and do this and do that. We pray, God, that we'll never, ever take for granted the fact, God, that you have allowed us to be amongst the land of the living. We pray that we'll never take for granted the fact, God, that where we're clothed, like we spoke about on yesterday at noon, like Legion being clothed, literally put clothes on his back, and God being in our right mind. Help us to never forget about the fact, God, that you provide for us, God, that you care for us. You said even the birds of the air, they don't sow, neither do they reap. But yet and still, God, you provide for them every day. The flowers of the field, God, they sow, neither do they reap, but yet you provide for them. You take care of the animal kingdom. You take care of this system, God, this world system that kind of just goes and just kind of does what it does. But you take care of it, and yet and still, God, you take care of us. We are, we've been created in your image, God. We're the Imago Dei. We've been created in your image. We're your image bearers. And God, we know that you take care of us. And we thank you for that. Thank you for your provision. Thank you for always giving us exactly what we need. God, we may not get what we desire. We may not get what we want. But God, we get exactly what we need. And God, you give us just enough grace that we need, God, to be able to handle whatever situation that we may be encountering. God, you open doors for us, God, right in the nick of time. And God, for that, we tell you thank you. We thank you, God, that you'll shut doors and you'll close doors. It's not according to your plan and your purpose. And there, I know that there's been times in my life, God, that I was hurt, that I was offended, that I was just downright mad about the fact that some doors had been slammed. But then, God, when I continued to go down the hallway and continued the journey in life, God, I began to thank you, God, for slamming that door, because that door was not the door that you had designed for my life. And God, at times we're upset about how things go. We're upset about the firing. We're upset about the betrayal. We're upset about the separation. We're upset about what it seems like we lost. But God, whenever it is, God, that you're in the business of doing it, God, those things that we lose, those things that literally have slammed in our face, God, it is really a promotion. It's literally addition through subtraction. And for that, we tell you thank you. It doesn't feel good, doesn't look good, doesn't taste good, doesn't sound good all the time, but it's all working together for our good. And we thank you. We give you glory and honor, God, even when we don't want it, even when we don't want to experience it, God. We thank you, God. We can echo, like the psalmist said in Psalm 119, it was good for me that I had been afflicted, because of the fact, God, that I was afflicted, God, I learned your statutes, I learned your word like never before. Many of us have that testimony. Many of us have that same declaration. And if we hadn't been through what we've been through, then God, we wouldn't be as close to you as we are. We would not have experienced you in a way, God, like never before, like we experienced you when we needed to experience you, when we needed to get drawn near to you. Thank you for that, God, that you allow situations and trouble, and you allow the ups and the downs and the indifferent seasons, God. You allow all of that, God, to woo us, to draw us, to call us, God, and to your side. And we thank you for that. We thank you, God, that we did not back up. We thank you, God, that we did not draw back. The Hebrew writer says, you don't take any pleasure of the soul that draws back. But no, you said not to cast away our confidence, for it has great recompense of reward. For we have need of patience, that after we've suffered a little while, God, we'll be able to endure. We'll be able to make it. And I pray right now in the name of Jesus for every individual that may be experiencing something or going through something or facing something. I pray, God, that there be no drawback in their spirit. I pray, God, that there be no retaliation in their spirit. I pray, God, that there be no retreat in their spirit. I pray that there don't be any white flag waving in their spirit. But if they're going to wave a flag, God, let it be a victory banner. If they're going to wave a flag, let it be in the fact, God, if we are going to surrender, let us surrender our will. Let us surrender our agenda. Let us surrender, God, our motive. Let us surrender how we think things ought to be. And God, let us be able, God, to give you the will. And God, be able to bow our knee in humble submission to your will, your word, your name, your way. God, we give your name the glory. I pray for the individuals right now that are going through the trials of their life. I'm praying for the individuals, God, that's going through something so severe, God, that they never saw it coming. They never would have even imagined they had to go through it. But I pray, God, that you'll wrap your arms around them right now in the name of Jesus, God, and come alongside them to be their burden bearer. Come alongside them, God, to walk with them, to talk with them, to tell them that they belong to you. We give your name the glory. God, I'm reminded even of those disciples in Luke chapter 24 that was on their way to Emmaus after your death and your burial, and consequently the time of your resurrection. They were so despondent. They were so discouraged. They was walking to this town, walking to this village, communicating with the Lord, and didn't realize they was even talking to you. They were so consumed with their trouble and so consumed with what they were going through. They didn't even recognize who it was that they were dealing with. And sometimes, God, that's how our life is. Sometimes, God, that's how our plights are. God, the fact, God, we're so consumed with what it is that we're experiencing and we're going through, that God, we don't even see the fact, God, that you are walking with us. We don't even see the fact that you're communicating with us in our pain. You're walking with us and communicating with us, God, and you're sharing with us in our trauma. And God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus, that any person, God, is on their Emmaus road, any individual, any family, any group of people, God, that is walking out out this thing, God, after the most devastating thing they could ever experience, after the most traumatic thing that they ever could have had imagined. I pray right now in the name of Jesus, God, that they will hear your voice. I pray right now in the name of Jesus, they will see the manifestation, God, of what it is that you're doing in their life. And God, even as you was communicating with these brothers and was asking what was going on, and they began to rehearse everything that was going on and begin to say that how the lady said that our Lord and our master had risen from the dead, but it seemed to them as idle tales. It seemed to them just like fables. It seemed to them just like stories. And God, we can be so familiar with you and so familiar with your word, God, that it becomes to us like idle tales. We know that no weapon formed against us will be able to prosper. We know that my God shall supply all I need according to his riches and glory. We know you turn the water into wine, and we know you talk to the woman at the well, and we know that after 3 days you rose again. And we can come so familiar with your word, God, the way your word is not familiar to our hearts and our minds. We can come so familiar, God, with the passage of scripture, so familiar, God, with the story, so familiar with the narrative, so familiar with that verse of scripture, God, to where we're not allowing it, God, to have an impact on our heart and our mind the way that it's supposed to have an impact on our heart and our mind. But right now, in the name of Jesus, God, we're praying, God, that your word don't ever get so familiar with your word that God is not potent. Oh no, but you told us in your word in Hebrews 4:12 that your word is a two-edged sword. Oh, it cuts and it divides, God. We thank you that your word is quick and it's powerful. It's alive. We thank you that your word, God, if we really, 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 really look at our Bible really closely sitting on that coffee table, we'll see it inhaling and exhaling and breathing. God, we pray, God, that we'll see, God, that your word is alive. It's not a dead book. It's not a dead letter, but no, God, it's alive. God, it is life. And God, we thank you for that, God, the way your word, God, it's dynamic, God. It's life-giving and it's impactful, God. And that's the potential, oh God, to change the very trajectory of our destiny if, God, we will apply it to our lives. We give your name the glory and the honor and the praise. And I pray for every person, God, that's going through something right now. And it seems like the word has become like Charlie Brown mama to them. And God, they just hear it, but they don't hear it and hear it. But I pray right now in the name of Jesus, God, the way you'll give us a fresh set of ears. I pray right now in the name of Jesus, you'll open our hearts and our minds to receive your engrafted word that is able to build us up, God. Thank you for your word, God, is everything that we need to build us up. Thank you that your word is everything that we need, God, to be able to solidify us, to fortify us, God, to where we'll be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding. We say, God, cut us with your word. Perform open heart surgery. Do what you do, God. Cut out anything in our heart that's not like you. Divide the soul and the spirit, God. Cut and divide, God. Separate, sever. Do whatever it is you need to do, God. Cut out any part of us, God, that does not align, God, with what it is that you desire in our hearts and our minds. In the name of Jesus, we give your name the glory. We give your name the honor. We give your name the praise, God. We thank you, God, because we have been encountering you, God, in these several days as we've been praying, and as we have been bombarding heaven, as this is the 13th day, God, as we've been bombarding heaven, as we've been calling on your name, God. We've been encountering you, but at the same time, God, we've been encountering, God, satanic attacks as well. We've been encountering satanic scenarios as well. But God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that we don't allow what the enemy is doing, oh God, to thwart or to throw off, God, or to cancel what it is that you're doing in our life. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that when the enemy raises up his heel, when the enemy raises up his head, when the enemy lifts up his hand, God, it won't get us so discouraged and won't cause us to be so distracted that we forget about all the things that you've done in our hearts and in our minds. Oh no, the devil is a lie. Oh God, we're going to recognize that the enemy is going to come. We're going to expect that the enemy is going to come. We're going to know that the enemy just doing his job, and we're going to continue to do our job. We thank you, God, oh, that what we have come to know in the light, oh God, we will not let it go in the darkness. The thing that you expose us to, God, in the light, the things that you expose us to when things were going well, the things that you exposed to us, God, when our body was whole and our body was healed and our body was healthy. Oh God, is what we're gonna hold on to, God, when we're coughing. It's gonna what we're gonna hold on to when we're wheezing. It's what we're gonna hold on to when we're weak and we're frail. It's what we're gonna hold on to, God, when our bodies are ravishing with pain. We're gonna hold on to it, God. The thing that you let us experience, God, in the light. Oh, when our relationship was healthy and whole, and God, we was finishing one another's sentences. Oh, and we just talked all night and talked all day. Oh, it's the thing we're gonna hold on to when things aren't going so well, when things aren't going according to plan and according to purpose. Oh, but right now, God, in the name of Jesus, we're gonna hold on to what it is that you've shown us, God. We're gonna hold on to what it is that we see. We give your name the glory this morning. We give your name the honor, God, because you're doing something fresh and you're doing something real in the lives of your people. We thank you for the remnant of your people, God, the way you always have your people. You always have your pocket of people. You always have your group of people, God, that's yet holding on when it seemed like everybody is turning away, when it seemed like everybody else is doing their own thing. You had to straighten Elijah out with that because he thought he was the only one, God, that was standing up. He thought he was the only one prophesying, the only one preaching, the only one doing miracle, signs and wonders. You told him in that cave, you said, what you doing in this cave, boy? And he said, oh, you think you the only one? I got 7,000 that have never bowed their knee down to Baal and never kissed his golden image. Oh, God, you had to let him know, God, that you always got your people. You always got your somebody praying. You always got your somebody lifting up a bloodstained banner. You always got your somebody that's doing what it is that they need to do. And God, we're a part of that last day army. We are part of the remnant. We're not the only ones. We're not the best ones. We're not the most effective ones, but we're one of the ones, God, that you called, that you've ordained, God, that you set aside for such a time as this. Help us, Lord, to step up to the plate and to do what it is that you so called us to do, God. Help us to be like Esther, God, that where we won't think we're just in the kingdom. Oh, God, just to be going through the motion. But no, God, you got us in the kingdom, God, that where we can bring about deliverance to the people of God. You got us in the kingdom, God, that where we might be able to be used by you. You got us in the kingdom, God, that where you can be able to utilize our influence and utilize, God, our position and utilize our power, God, the way your purposes and your will and your plan can be done in the earth. And just like Mordecai told Esther, oh, if you don't step up, Esther, God will raise somebody else up, oh, to do what it is that needs to be done. Deliverance will come from another place. And God, help us to always keep that in mind, that you always got your people. You always got your remnant. And God, if we don't step up, if we don't do what we're called to do, oh, deliverance will come from another place. But God, you don't got to send nobody else, God, to do what it is you called us to do. You don't got to raise up a David for us because we're not Saul. Oh, you don't got to tell us like you told Saul, I found a neighbor that's better than you. Oh, that'll do all my will. No, you don't got to tell us that, God. We don't want to be Saul. We don't want to be stiff-necked. We don't want to be rebellious. We don't ever want to be, we don't want to be unrepentant. Oh, but no, God, we don't want you to replace us with anybody. But God, we desire for you to do what it is that you called us to do in our lives. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we call on your name, God. Right now, God, we ask you right now as we call on you, as we're praying, as we're believing, as we're seeking your face. We just ask you to do what only you can. We're praying this morning, God, specifically, as our prayer target is this morning. God, we are praying during this time of consecration, oh, that we will bring our finances in alignment with the word of God. And therefore we decree and we declare that we will walk in kingdom prosperity, increase and overflow in every area of our lives. We pray, God, that where we will be able, you need a heart first, God, before you ever get our pocketbook, God, you need our heart. One writer said there's three conversions. There's a conversion of the heart. There's a conversion of the mind. And then there's a conversion of the wallet or the conversion of the pocketbook. And God, that's why we've been strategic on this time of consecration. That's why that wasn't the first thing we prayed about or the second thing we prayed about. Oh, but God, as we're in the middle of this thing and as God, you're working and as you're flowing and as you're working with us and as you've been pulling some things out of us and pulling some things out of our heart and our mind and putting some things in. Now, God, here comes another conversion. conversion. You converted our heart. You're converting our mind. And now, God, we're saying to you, God, that you can convert our wallet. You can convert our money, God. What's ours, God, it belongs to you. Help us to have that mindset. Help us to know, God, that every good and every perfect gift, it comes from you. Help us to have that mindset, God, that the cattle on a thousand hill belongs to you, and you even own the hill. Help us to have that mindset, God, that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and those and they that dwell therein. You own everything, God. We give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. Thank you, God, for owning everything. And we have had that mindset. If we will remember, God, that you're sovereign. If we remember, God, that you're in control of everything. If we remember, God, that you're master everything. Oh, God, we won't become stingy when it comes to our resources. We won't become stingy when it comes, God, to us releasing, God, our finances into the kingdom of God. Oh, because you gave us a strength. Oh, that's what you told us in your word. It's you that give us power to get well. It's you that give us the power to go out there and work. It's you that given us the ability, God, to be able to go and get that degree. It's you, God, that gave us the ability, God, to go out and to do what we need to do. We think it was because of our savvy interview skills. Oh, but God, you gave us the interview skill. We thought it was because we pulled ourselves up and drug ourselves through school, and we had to work a full-time job, and we was a full-time student. We think it was because of what we did. But no, God, it was you that gave us that energy. It was you, God, to help us do well on tests. It was you, God, that caused us to be able to study. It was you, God, that did it. It was not the hookup that we got. It wasn't the scholarship. It wasn't the full ride and the free ride. Oh, but no, God, it was you that caused us to, God, to matriculate through whatever way we matriculated. Oh, God, to be wherever we are, God, it's you that did it. God, help us to always remember that. Help us to always know that. Help us to always tell our children, oh, you're living in this house, oh, because God did it. Oh, you're riding this car because God did it. You eating good because God did it. Oh, you're dressing good and wearing good and doing all that because God did it. Help us never to take the credit and say it's because mama did what she needed to do and daddy did. And we understand we got to teach them values and morals and hard work and determination. Oh, we'll get that, God, but let the conversation don't start there. Oh, but let the conversation start. Oh, daddy got what he got because it's God. Oh, daddy living and mama able to do what we able to do because God is doing it. It's you, God, that give us power to get well. And we thank you for it, God. We give your name the glory and the honor for where we are in our lives. Many of us, God, are dressing better than we ever dressed. Many of us are living better than we ever lived and driving better than we've ever driven. We're in a place, God, that where we've never been, and we know it's not about the stuff and it's not about the cash and the clothes and the cars. Oh, but God, you don't mind us having those things as long as those things don't have us. Oh, but God, many of us are doing well in our life. Many of us are doing financially well. Help us, Lord, never to forget, God, where we came from. Help us to never forget, God, that it's because of your good hand being upon us, God, that we're doing what we do. And because we'll never forget. Oh, we won't get cirrhosis of the giver. Oh, God, we'll always have our hand out. We'll always, God, have an open hand. We'll always, God, be able to give and be able to sow and be able to let go, God, because it came from you. Help us to know it came from you. Help us to know, God, that it didn't come from us, but God, it came from you. Every good and every perfect gift, it come down from the Father of light. We give your name the glory, God. That's why we don't mind sowing. That's why we don't mind giving. That's why we don't mind giving you at least a tenth of what we have. We don't get caught up in this argument about tithe. Oh, God, that's the least that we can do is give you 10% of our income. That's the least that we can do, God, to be able to give you everything that comes in our hand. God, to honor you, God, with the first fruit of what we have. We give your name the glory and the honor. I pray right now in the name of Jesus for the individuals that may be struggling in this area, for the individuals that may be still carnal in their thinking and thinking that pastor trying to get an offering out of them. Oh, the offering is not for pastor. The offering is not even in a real sense for truth and love. Oh, but the offering is for you. The offering is for the people. And God, that's the revelation you had to give me way back in 2016, when I finally turned the corner and started teaching on giving and started teaching on tithing. You rebuked me and told me that I'm holding the people of God back. I'm stopping them from being blessed because I don't want nobody to think I'm big pimping. I'm stopping the people of God from being blessed. And God, you're trying to get something not from them, but you're trying to get something to them. And God, I was holding them back because I didn't want to be associated, God, with the prosperity preachers and this and that. Oh, but God, you had to get me straight and say, not about me, but God, it's about what it is that you desire. desiring to do in your word. I can't skip over your word and act like it's not there because of my own personal feelings. And God, I thank you for that. And God, that needs to be our mindset. That God is not that you're trying to get anything from us, but God, you're trying to get something to us. It's God, when we walk in generosity, it's when we live in generosity. It's when we sow our seed, God. It's when you able, God, to be able to allow our lives, God, to reflect that. To allow our lives, God, to reflect the fact, God, that our entire relationship is based on generosity. Our entire existence is based on generosity. It's our entire fact that where we're going to spend eternity with you in heaven is based on the fact that you are a generous God. Oh, you said in your word, for God so loved the world that he gave. The fact that we know you is the fact that you gave. The fact that you've forgiven us of our sins is because you gave. The fact that you wash us and cleanse us and purge us is the fact that you gave. Oh, God, we thank you, God, that we don't mind giving back. We don't mind exalting you. We don't mind honoring you, God. We don't mind, God, putting you first, God, when it comes to our money. And I pray for every individual, God, that maybe where I was, God, had a poverty mentality, had a broke mentality, and God just was living hand to mouth, and God was just looking at them $60 when I first got saved, and looked at those $60 and thought that was the world, and thought, how in the world can I give this church my money? How in the world can I give this man my money? My carnal thinking. Oh, but God, I thank you that you had mercy on me. I thank you, God, that you worked with me. I thank you, God, that you worked on me. I thank you, God, that you waited on me, God, and when I got the revelation, oh, that I'm not giving to a man. When I got the revelation, it didn't matter how many thousands of people was in the room. Oh, God, that it wasn't the fact, God, that my money didn't make a difference. But, God, I needed to do my part. I needed to know, God, that I need to honor you, God, for what it is that you have given me. And, God, I needed to do my part because I was connected to a family. I was connected to a community. And, God, it's not about us just doing everything and pulling all of the weight. But, God, only thing you require of us, God, is for us to do our part. And I pray right now in the name of Jesus for individuals that may be where I was. And God, I called it young. I called it at a young age. But God, there's some that's been walking with you a long time. We don't mind serving. We don't mind singing. We don't mind preaching. We don't mind serving in whatever capacity. But when it comes to that money, God, we real stingy. When it comes to that money, God, we hit and miss it. When it comes to that money, we're like, oh, I don't know about that. When it comes to that money, we just can't let it go. But we pray in the name of Jesus, God, that where we will loosen our grip when it comes to this world. That's what it's all about. It's about thinking that we're going to miss out, thinking that we're not going to be able to live the way we want to live and to buy the stuff that we desire to buy. And we're so held on to this world. But God, we pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you'll do whatever you need to do, God, to loosen our grip on this world, to loosen our grip. God, what shall it profit a man for him to gain the whole world and to lose his soul? And God, help us to know that, God, the tighter we are and the more stingier we are, that's the more that we lose out. But we pray right now in the name of Jesus, God, that we won't be so caught up in purses, won't be so caught up in our hair and our nails and our lips and tips and fingertips. We will not be so caught up in our Jordans and our shoes and our polo shirts. We won't be so caught up in our tailor clothes and our designer bags and all of this. We won't be so caught up in all of those things. Oh, well, God, we'll be caught up in you. And when we seek you first and all of your righteousness and all those things, God, you said, oh God, you said they'll be added unto us. We're not consumed with those things. Those things don't make us or break us. Oh, but God, it is you, God. It is you that we pursue. It is you, God, that we give. And God, we want to steward. God, we want to be good stewards over our resources right now in the name of Jesus. And God, just because we tithe and just because we honor you, God, with the first 10% of our income, that don't mean we just go out there and splurge the rest. That don't mean we can go out there and drink up the rest and smoke up the rest and gamble up the rest. Oh no, that's not how that works. We might as well go and take the whole 100% and do what the devil we want to do if we're going to go out there with the rest of it and mismanage it and not honor you with it. But God, I pray, God, that you'll give us insight, and I pray that you'll give us wisdom even how to manage the rest that's left. God, you'll be able to breathe on what's left. You'll be able to multiply what's left. You'll be able to stretch what's left. God, you will be like that widow woman, God, with the prophet, that God, our oil and our meal will never never run out. We'll be like God, we'll be like that when you're stretching us. We'll be like that little lad with those two fish and five loaves. Oh God, it just kept breaking and kept breaking and kept breaking and kept breaking. And you expanded and expanded and expanded it and fed God over 5,000, not counting the men and the, not counting the women rather, and the children. We thank you, God, that where you're able to expand what we have. We thank you, God, that you're able to breathe on what we have. Many of us have testimonies, God, where we was getting unemployment check, and God, living good. One woman of God in particular, one family in particular, tells a story about how they was unemployed, living on unemployment checks, and they had so much food in their freezer that they had to come get to give it away. They had so much food and stuff coming from everywhere, and just didn't have room, literally. Didn't have room enough to receive. Help us to walk in that way. Help us to walk in that manner, God, that where we know, God, that you're increasing us. God, that you desire, God, for us to be an overflow. And God, we can be an overflow even when we're not making $100,000 a year. But God, we can be an overflow. We're not making $150,000 and $200,000, not making $500,000. Oh, but God, we can be walking in overflow. We can be working on our job, working our 40 hours a week, God, making minimum wage and being overflow. Oh, God, we can just be doing what we need to do. God, just working our fingers to the bone and honoring you, God. And God, I'm honoring you with our time, with our talent and our resources. And we can be living in overflow, and we can have enough and more than enough. We thank you, God, that where we pray like the Apostle Paul said, oh, God, that you are able to make all grace abound towards us in everything. So we have everything we need in every situation. I pray that over your people right now. Oh, your people, God, that are giving and sowing into this work. Oh, God, I pray they have everything that they need. Oh, God, in every situation, God, that all grace will abound to every good work. And God, that anytime we have a need, oh, anytime something come up, oh, when the garage door go out, oh, when the AC go out, oh, when the plumbing goes out, oh, when the engine goes out, when the tires blow, oh, when the tuition is due, oh, God, when the light bill due, whenever it is that we need, God, oh, we'll have everything that we need. We'll be walking in overflow. We give your name the glory for it. We give your name the honor. And God, help us to always keep the main thing. Not the way we are honoring you. And God, the way it is that the giving and the tithing, God, and our offerings and the special sacrificial giving. Oh God, it is for us. Oh, but God, at the same time, it's for the advancement of your kingdom. I pray, God, the way every seed is sown into Truth and Love Ministries. I thank you, God, the way you'll breathe on it exponentially. And I pray, God, that everything that we have, just like you do it in the natural, just like you do it for individuals and individuals' home, do it for the body of Christ as well. Every dime that's given, God, you are called it to expand. Every dime that's given, God, first and foremost, we will manage it properly. First and foremost, God, we will do what it is, God, that you designed for us to do. And God, we won't blow it, and we won't make foolish decisions. But God, we will handle the resources, God, that you've allowed to come into our hand. And God, we will handle it in a way, God, that's edifying to you and that's honoring to you. And we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. And when we do that, oh God, you're going to cause us, God, to be able to expand our worship facility. When we do that, you're going to cause us to be able to build out that dome. And when we do that, you're going to cause us, God, to be able to purchase land and purchase buildings. And God, when we do that, we're going to have that youth empowerment center that's going to have the computer labs and the classrooms and the game rooms. And when we do that, God, we're going to have that facility, God, that we're able to be able to feed people on a daily basis. And when we do that, we're going to be able to give away groceries and hot food and dry food every day. And when we do that, God, you're going to be able to breathe on our efforts and our energy. Oh, like you're already doing. Even where we at, we feeding all these people every single year, God. Thousands of people that we help on a yearly basis. Whenever it is that we're doing our dome initiative, and we're giving out our pantries, and we're doing what we do on Wednesdays, and what we're doing on first Saturday and fourth Saturday, Callaway Cold. Oh God, over and over and over again. You're going to do that in a greater way. You're going to do that in an exponential way. God, the way we're able to be able to bless people to go to college, the way we're able, God, to purchase homes and sow them into people's lives and purchase vehicles that people that need them, God, and sow it into their life. We'll be able to do so much, much, much more. And God, we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, that when we do what we do together, oh God, we're able to go further, God. We're able to do more. And God, we're so thankful for that understanding. I pray for every person on the sound of my voice. I pray for all of our marriages, that our marriages, that we be on one accord when it comes to our finances, and we be on one accord when it comes to everything that we do. And when we're on one accord, God, you'll breathe on our marriages. I pray, God, that you will allow our marriages to flow, allow our marriages to grow, allow our marriages to be healthy in the name of Jesus. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. What God have joined together, you cannot put asunder. And God, we thank you for deliverance in that area. We thank you, God, for you being with us in that area. Thank you for our singles, that you keep them focused and keep them faithful and keep their hearts and their minds stayed on you. We pray for our children. Pray for our babies, God. God, we pray that you'll keep them from all hurt, all danger, all incidents and all accidents. We pray, God, the way you will just continue to insulate them from individuals that don't mean them no good, the peer pressure, the bullies, all the things that's going on that they have to deal with on a daily basis. I can't imagine how much of a heathen I would be, God, if I was growing up in this day and time. I can't imagine how lost I would be. I couldn't imagine how perverted I would be if I had all the access to all the things to my fingertips. Oh God, that the children have now. Oh God, it's difficult enough for the grown folk to do right. It's difficult enough for the folk that know better to do right. I can't imagine being a child. And I pray in the name of Jesus that you will help our children and be with our children, God, even when they don't know, even when they're being allured, even when they're being drawn away, God, and being enticed. God, I pray, God, that you'll be with them. And God, I pray, God, that they don't make any decisions or do anything, God, that will affect them, God, for the remainder of their lives. But I pray, God, that you'll put them around the right people that'll help them. I pray, God, that you'll download a no in their spirit when they're being offered something, God, that's not your will or your plan. And we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Keep our young babies, keep our middle-aged babies, keep our old babies, our grown babies, our grandbabies, our nieces, our nephews, every child that's in our lives, God, we ask you to keep them from the hurt and the harm and the danger. And I pray a special prayer for Brother Johnson, Willie Johnson. That's my Philippian family. He and his wife, whose daughter transitioned on yesterday, who have been battling cancer for several years. She put up a good fight. Such a beautiful soul, beautiful young lady, author, so young, but yet and still, God, she transitioned, and I pray for that family. I can't imagine saying goodbye to one of my babies. As much as I love my children, I cannot imagine having to say goodbye in that capacity. So we pray for that Johnson family, that you'll touch them and strengthen them and help them and be with them during these challenging times. And I pray for every person, God, that may have lost a child or had to say goodbye to a child. A child has transitioned. I pray, God, that you will wrap your arms around them and you'll be with them and you'll comfort them and you'll strengthen them as only you can. I pray for every person that's lost anybody, whether it's a child, whether it's a spouse, whether it's a parent, whether it's a friend. God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you'll be with them and strengthen them and help them walk with them through these difficult seasons. And God, we know you're going to get the glory and the honor from it. God, you don't put nothing on us, God, that we can't recover from. And God, I thank you, God. We don't have to qualify our pain. We don't got to measure our pain with somebody else. We don't got to say, well, you don't understand, or well, you never lost this, or never, you've never been there. We don't have to say anything foolish like that. But God, no matter where we are, God, you're able to bring us strength. You're able to bring us comfort. And God, you're able to be with us every step of the way. I pray for every person under the sound of my voice, whether we're heading to work, whether we're home, whether we're already at work, maybe we're on our way back from work, maybe we're driving, the truck drives us out there on the highways and the byways. Can't imagine. I pray a special blessing on them as they're away from their family, some of them for days on end, weeks on end, just to provide for their family. Can't imagine being on that road all that time, all that driving, and yet you're keeping them sober, keeping them vigilant, you're being with them. I say all of them a little touch, because I pray that you'll keep them all and strengthen them all as they're out there doing what they do provide, and keep them sober and vigilant, and keep them, God, keep them aware, keep them from all accidents and incidents, and all those individuals that have those types of employment, those types of jobs, those types of careers. I pray that you'll be with them all of our medical professionals and every person. God, I start going out all the careers, every person in every career and every phase and every age that we may be in. I pray, God, that you'll be with us and strengthen us all. God, that we'll be able to bring you glory and honor in everything that we do. And we thank you in advance for all that you've done and all that you're going to do. And it's in Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Well, I love y'all, Truth to Love Nation. I was just about to turn the corner and crank up and turn another gear and start praying about the careers and all that. Maybe another time. Maybe Lord be with us. And man, I love y'all. Thank God for you. Truck drivers, y'all know I love y'all. I'm messing with y'all, and I say that to y'all all the time. Y'all be out there on that road, be in that truck by yourself, and y'all just different. So I thank God for all of y'all, and I appreciate you. Thank you for your faithfulness, Truth and Love Nation. Your commitment this time, this moment, this prayer. Man, we're in for the long haul. We're going to be praying tonight at 6 p.m. at the facility. Let us do what we need to do. Let us continue to bombard heaven and continue to show up and do what we need to do as the body of Christ. I'm actually in South Carolina with my family. My daughter, Kendall, has in the gymnastics competition. So I'm on daddy duty, left out last night and on the road doing what I need to do. But I brought that up just to say this, that even if I'm not in the facility tonight, y'all do what y'all need to do. It's not based on me, not built on me. And even I'm still holding down my part. I'm out here in the cold and I'm in my car. Everybody's in the room, in the hotel room, so I didn't want to wake them up. So I'm out here in my car and holding down prayer, doing what I need to do. And so at times, for God, we don't mind. And not at times, we don't mind sacrificing, and we don't mind inconveniencing ourselves, and don't mind doing whatever we need to do to be able to honor God with the very best that we have. So if pastor can do it, you can do it. We don't got to complain about it. We don't got to brag about it. We got to do nothing. We just need to do what we need to do and be on the wall and bring God glory and honor. All right. I love y'all. I pray you have a fly Friday on purpose. Let the Lord bless you and keep you. Pray for us as we're here, and we'll be back. We'll be back. Be the Lord's will sometime tomorrow. And we'll be doing what we need to do. All right. I love y'all. I thank God for you. All right, may Lord bless you and keep you. Here come the church. Peace out. Bye-bye.